Welcome to Daily Scripture and Meditation with Shirley Celise Jackson. We begin, as always, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Monday, the 17th of July 2023, of the 15th week in Ordinary Time. Grant me your grace, most merciful Jesus, that it may be with me, and labor with me, and continue with me unto the end. Grant me always to will and desire that which is most acceptable to you, and which pleases you best. Daily Prayer. Lord, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no heart has conceived the things you have prepared for those who love you. Set us ablaze with the fire of the Holy Spirit, that we may love you in and above all things, and so receive the rewards you have promised through Christ our Lord. Amen. Introduction to the Liturgy of the Word. We want to be worthy of Jesus Christ. We want to find our life, our true life, by losing our life for His sake. When life becomes bitter for us, with hard work in mortar and brick, and even if one's enemies will be those of his household, we take up our cross and follow after Jesus with the confidence that we will share in His resurrection. The Epistle. Come, let us deal shrewdly with them to stop their increase. A reading from the book of Exodus, chapter 8, verse 1. A new king who knew nothing of Joseph came to power in Egypt. He said to his subjects, "Look how numerous and powerful the people of the children of Israel are growing, more so than we ourselves. Come, let us deal shrewdly with them to stop their increase. Otherwise, in time of war, they too may join our enemies to fight against us and so leave our country." Accordingly, taskmasters were set over the children of Israel to oppress them with forced labor. Thus they had to build for Pharaoh the supply cities of Pithom and Ramses. Yet the more they were oppressed, the more they multiplied and spread. The Egyptians then dreaded the children of Israel and reduced them to cruel slavery, making life bitter for them with hard work in mortar and brick and all kinds of field work, the whole cruel fate of slaves. Pharaoh then commanded all his subjects, "Throw into the river every boy that is born to the Hebrews, but you may let all the girls live." The Word of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Psalm 124. Responsorial Verse. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Had not the Lord been with us, let Israel say, had not the Lord been with us when men rose up against us, then they would have swallowed us alive when their fury was inflamed against us. Our hope is in the name of the Lord. Then would the waters have overwhelmed us, the torrent would have swept over us. Over us then would have swept the raging waters. Blessed be the Lord who did not leave us a prey to their teeth. Our help is in the name of the Lord. We were rescued like a bird from the fowler's snare. Broken was the snare, and we were freed. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Gospel Acclamation.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Gospel. I have come to bring not peace, but the sword. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew chapter 10, verse 34. Jesus said to his apostles, "Do not think that I have come to bring peace upon the earth. I have come to bring not peace, but the sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law, and one's enemies will be those of his household. Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me. Whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man because he is righteous will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink because he is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." When Jesus finished giving these commands to his 12 disciples, he went away from that place to teach and to preach in their towns. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Meditation. I have come to bring not peace, but the sword. Matthew chapter 10, verse 34. At first glance, this passage might stop us in our tracks. Wasn't Jesus' whole mission about peace and reconciliation? So why the sword? How can Jesus be the Prince of Peace, but also be preparing us for conflict? Jesus knew that many people would not accept him or his message. He also knew that this could lead to division, sometimes even within a family. As he warned, "I have come to set a man against his father, a daughter against her mother." Matthew chapter 10, verse 35. Any kind of division like this is tragic. And yet, God has given every human being the freedom to accept or reject him. He loves each one of us beyond our comprehension. But he won't force his love on anyone. For a variety of reasons, many people are unable to accept God's personal love for them or the blessings that come with being one with Jesus. We all want every person to come to know the Lord, but we must also expect at times to experience pushback, conflict, or even division when we try to share our faith. In such situations, it's important not to let our witness turn into an attempt just to convince someone of the truth. Too often, conversations like these create deeper divisions rather than the unity and healing that Jesus longs for. Instead, we can focus on preaching the gospel not just with our words, but with the love and compassion of the one who is himself the truth. John chapter 14, verse 6. Jesus knew that his coming would cause division and conflict. At the same time, He is the only one who can bring true peace and unity. So let's strive to be Christ to those who have not yet accepted the gospel, but who still long for the love that only He can give. Let's take the advice of St. Paul and put on heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Colossians chapter 3, verse 12. May the witness of Jesus' life in us be the catalyst that sparks faith in our loved ones and in everyone we will encounter today. Jesus, Prince of Peace, help me reflect your love and compassion to everyone who is far from you. Amen. We are God's hands, feet, and voice. May His peace rest upon you as you go and announce the gospel of the Lord in your words and deeds. Thank you for joining today. Abundant blessings upon you and yours. Amen. We close as always in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hello, I'm Shirley, residential realtor for many years. As a professional, I welcome and encourage you to contact me whether you are buying or selling a home. Or if you know like-minded people like yourself that you want me to help guide through this overwhelming process. Whether in the Dallas Metroplex or across the country, I'd love to assist in your real estate needs. Click the link in the description below to land on my website for a plethora of real estate information. Thank you, and blessings upon you and yours.